All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Peter Clausi. He is the Vice President of Capital Markets for Silver Bullet Mines. And Peter, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing very well today. Yesterday, we had a busy day with the new press release. It's been really good times.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a lot of things going on, and we want to learn all about it. But first, give me sort of a bit of background on Silver Bullet.
Silver Bullet is a story unlike one you've ever heard before. This is the Pat Sheridan School of Mining. You don't need a PEA, you don't need a resource estimate, you don't need a feasibility study. If you know where the mineralization is, go get it. We're in Globe, Arizona, five past producers. We're putting the Buckeye Mine back into production. Every time I tell this story for the first time, I hear, yeah, that can't be true. And when I get to the end of the story, people say, oh my God, it's true. How can I get some shares? We are in pilot production in 4 weeks in a primary silver mine near Globe, Arizona. Globe is like Sudbury or Schumacher. It exists for mining. Mm-hmm. So we have all the infrastructure we need. We have the mining wisdom we need, and we have mineralization.
So when people say that to you, that they don't believe your story, what is it they don't believe about it? Is the fact that you're able to do this with what? What have you been able to accomplish without doing those other things that you mentioned?
Raise money, raise a lot of money, and show that the mineralization is there. The press release that we put out on March 1st talked about breaking into the treasure room. From this site, historically, and well before 43-101, they direct shipped ore on donkey back to a smelter. I think that went to San Francisco. Do you know how high grade it has to be to do direct shipping that great a distance? So there was no concentrate. They didn't process it. Came out of the ground, onto the donkey, and off the donkey train went. There was a collapse in 1873. Human eyes have not laid sight on the treasure room until Sunday of this week. We have video of it at our website, and it is absolutely beautiful. It is a vastly mineralized zone. You can see the historic drifts. The miners were going in every direction until the cave-in. And that's just one of the areas from which we will be pulling material.
Okay. Let's talk about the mill. You mentioned you're about 4 weeks away. Still some installation that's going on there right now. Just talk about getting that back into where it's able to operate and what sort of production you're looking at.
A year ago, that was an empty field. We bought 65 acres of land, patented land. We own it outright. And on that land, we built a mill. Our CEO, John Carter, is exceptionally skilled at the creation and installation of mills. He's built over 200 around the world. It's like John was born for this job. So we have a lot of confidence in the mill. We got hung up in Long Beach for about 3 months. Our drive train and the motor for the ball mill somehow got lost in a container. Instead of 20 days, it took about 75 to get through. We were supposed to be in production last quarter, and we missed because of that. And I can tell you, as a management team, we were very unhappy that we let down the investors by one quarter. All the parts are in, all the parts are installed except for the screen frame. And I think one conveyor still has to go on, which, you know, for you and me, Steve, we couldn't do that in a month. But for our field team, they'll do that in half a day. And then the mill is ready.
So now that the mill is near ready to go, are you ready with Buckeye as well? Is everything set to go and to start production?
We're there. We've already pulled 1,500 tons out of the Buckeye and put it on surface at the mill site. That's the stuff that we expect will be lower grade. You know, without a PEA, I can't tell you what ounces are, but it'll be lower grade. And we use that for the first 2 weeks as we fine-tune the mill. You want to get the conveyor belts running at the right speed in, the right speed out, get the pumps and the cyclones all synchronized. And once we're done that, then the higher grade material goes in. But the Buckeye's ready. It's ventilated. It's timbered. It's blown. Material's coming out. We have a little bobcat. There's a video on the website. You can see one of our guys driving the bobcat down the adit and then driving the bobcat back out of the adit with material.
Hmm. Peter, last question. That is, when this is all up and running, where does that take Silver Bullet? Where do you go from there?
We have five past producers we're putting back into production. Buckeye is number one. McMorris is number two. Not sure which number three, because we have to do some drilling. But we also have a property in Idaho. One of the good problems we have is that Idaho is better than we expected. We knew it was good, but it's turning out to be absolutely fantastic. There's a historic mine there as well. And prior owners mined it for the gold. And at 70 cent silver, they didn't want the silver. So they pulled the silver ore out and tossed it into the adits that drifts it on surface. Now that silver's $25 an ounce, it's worth a lot. So the basic battle plan would be to hire a contract miner to scrape that up, take it to a mill, toll mill it, and write us a check.
Makes a lot of sense. Well, Peter, congratulations on this. I know it's an exciting time in just a few more weeks, and you'll have everything up and running. We'd love to have you back, talk more about it when everything is good and this Buckeye is back running. So great to see you again. Thanks very much.
You as well. The Wi-Fi at the mine site is better than here at my house, apparently. So maybe we can do an interview from site. I'm going down the first week of April.
Absolutely. We'd love to talk to you. Thank you, Peter. Appreciate it.
Thanks for your time.
All right, Peter Clausi, the Vice President of Capital Markets for Silver Bullet Mines.